我超讨厌我的老板，我也快要离职了。I am sick and tired of my boss pushing me around, and I'm this close for quitting my job. If you're thinking about switching gears, leaving work, or maybe even going job hunting, we're going to be exploring some key words and phrases that you could use in Mandarin. Welcome to another edition of Useful Mandarin Words and Phrases provided by Glossika. My name is Mans, or you can call me Aman. If you're currently working in a Mandarin-speaking culture, or you're looking for work in a Mandarin-speaking culture, there might come a time where you end up wanting to leave. Now, it's best to find the opportune time to do this, and you gotta be familiar with the culture to do it right. In Mandarin-speaking cultures, there is always a Wei Ya, which is a Lunar New Year celebration or banquet run by the company. Usually, they offer a Nianzong Jiangjing, or a New Year's bonus, at the end of the Lunar New Year. That's probably the best time to leave. It's going to be holding on just tight enough to get that bonus and then moving on to your next level and next phase of fun employment. So we're going to explore some keywords here. A Wei Ya, Wei Ya, Wei Ya. That's the company banquet at the end of the Lunar New Year. Then you have your year-end bonus. Sometimes you just say year's end and it implies the bonus, or you can say the full phrase. Nianzong, Nianzong, or Nianzong Jiangjing. Nianzong Jiangjing. If you're hoping to find the opportune time, you wait until after Lunar New Year, and you decide to leave your work, you decide to quit your job, best way to say this would be Li Zi, Li Zi, Li Zi. Now, of course, you're fun employed and you're looking for future work. Well, you're on the hunt. In Mandarin, we would say 我在找工作, 我在找工作, 我在找工作. Or 找工作, 找工作. So in the process, you're going to be looking for creating a solid resume or a CV. In Mandarin, we would say 履历表, 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 or 履历, 履历. If you're in the process of looking for work, this is called 应征工作, 应征工作, 应征工作. If you line up some interviews, you want to make sure you stay organized, and you want to block out that calendar date for that interview as soon as possible. So one of the key questions you'd be asking is, when's the interview? 请问面试时间是什么时候? 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 Now, you found this job through a referral of a friend or somewhere online, but you need to have the details. Now, obviously, one of the most important details very often is your compensation, perks and benefits. Now there are subtle or direct ways of learning about your salary, perks and benefits. So one of the key ways to say salary is 薪水, 薪水, 薪水. Or you could think of it as 薪资, 薪资, 薪资. Now when you're interacting with your interviewer, you can ask, around what is the ballpark figure of my salary? 请问这个职位的薪水大概多少? 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 Now, if you want to be more subtle about this question, you could ask about the perks and benefits. 待遇, 待遇, 待遇. Now, if you're speaking to your interviewer and you want to put it in a sentence, you would ask, 请问这个工作的待遇是怎么样? 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 Now, in the entire interview process, you're obviously trying to be as polite as possible, and you want to maintain a high standard and good candor. So one of the best ways is, of course, what we do in English, we use the word esteemed. So you'd be highlighting and addressing this company or organization as your esteemed organization, your esteemed company. In Mandarin, we would say 贵公司, 贵公司, 贵公司. So now you've got a good collection of key words and phrases and things to be aware of in the culture. I'm wishing you the best of fun employment. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, 下次见. On behalf of Glossika, we wish you happy hunting.